Coming up on News Live at 6, a Marshall Street staple is closing its doors after 40 years. Our reporter Teagan Brown has more on what is happening with Acropolis.
Plus, SU student-run PR agency Hill Communications has agreed to a brand new partnership. Find out how some students could soon receive a boost to their professional careers.
And Ukraine is holding a National Day of Unity as a Russian invasion could happen any day, according to reports. We will discuss the latest developments later in the show. CitrusTV News Live at 6 starts right now.
This is CitrusTV News Live at 6, your campus news leader.
Acropolis, a staple on Marshall Street, is preparing to close its doors after 40 years. Good evening and welcome into News Live at 6. I'm Oscar Offerman.
And I'm Ashley Wenskoski. Acropolis, on the corner of University Avenue and Marshall Street, is handing over the keys to a popular fast food chain. Our reporter Teagan Brown is live on Marshall Street with the latest. Teagan, what can you tell us?
Ashley and Oscar, good evening. I'm here on Marshall Street where rain or shine, students are always walking here, going to different stores and different restaurants. But pretty soon, they won't be able to make their late night ventures to one of them. Acropolis has been here, like you said, for 40 years, since 1982. But come a few months, students will no longer be able to go here in order to make room for Popeyes. I spoke today with both students and local business owners around the restaurant about their reactions.
Marshall Street, a place where both students and members of the community come to take a stroll, buy some Q's gear, or get a slice of pizza. But if you want a slice of cheese or pepperoni, you won't be able to do so from Acropolis for much longer. Manager Eric Hicks of J. Michael Shoes, which is right next door, says this change isn't a surprise.
A sign of the times, I guess, would be the best way to describe it. There's less and less mom and pops on the street. From that long, you know, back then it was all mom and pop, so now you have more Starbucks, Chipotle's, now Popeyes.
Students make up the main crowd that comes into Acropolis, and some of them have made it part of their college experience and memories.
It's definitely going to be sad because, like, Acropolis, like, when I was a freshman, like, every night that we went out, we would go there, or, like, after a tailgate or something, and now it's going to be gone.
While upperclassmen have experienced the pizza place that has been here since 1982, younger students barely just got a taste. However, one freshman expressed her wants for a place with a local tie, while also acknowledging others' wants for a chain.
I would much prefer a local mom and pop. It's definitely my preference. I do have a neighbor who orders Popeyes like 4 times a week, so he'll be very happy to hear that. But
while Marshall Street won't look the same without Acropolis, they've still made their impact.
I'll miss them. You know, I've known them. I've worked here a long time, so I've known all the people there quite a long time. But I can certainly respect their decision to move on, especially after what we've all been through over the past couple of years.
If you want that last slice of Acropolis pizza, you better make sure to make your way here, because pretty soon you'll have to trade in that slice for some fried chicken instead. Reporting live from Marshall Street, Teagan Brown, CitrusTV News.
We'll be sad to see it go. Teagan Brown, thank you so much.
SU student-run PR agency Hill Communications has agreed to a brand new partnership. Green Hill Investment announced its fourth partnership with the ad firm this morning. CitrusTV reporter Ilana Epstein is in studio with more details. Ilana, what can you tell us?
Green Hill Investment Reporting and Hill Communications have been working together for 4 semesters. Melissa Cubitt, who is an alumni of Hill Communications, is the daughter of one of the executive vice presidents at Green Hill. She connected Hill Communications to Green Hill, and they've been working together ever since. Executives' roles in Green Hill changed, and new relationships were built over the years. Matthew Grant Patton, a member of Hill Communications at Syracuse University, says that they have worked together to rebrand Green Hill.
We aid them in all full service of public relations efforts, and we oftentimes do things that are beyond that scope to aid them in any way we can. It's a professional learning experience, but it's also a great community for public relations students.
Patton also says that Hill Communications gives students in any major professional learning opportunities. He says that students get to work personally with individual staff members of Green Hill and share their professional work with clients of Syracuse University and professional clients like Green Hill.
We have our own graphic design team here who helped us, and we created a new logo for them. We've updated their entire social media presence from nothing to a general existing presence. And they're currently working on a new website. So their aesthetic is completely rebranded. And we also help them in their visibility efforts. We help them with internal functionality and pretty much any tasks they want us to take on, researches, audits. We have a pretty extensive and personal relationship with them.
Patton says that students at Syracuse University get the opportunity to be part of what he believes is one of the premier PR firms for students in the whole country. Greenhill Investment Reporting and Hill Communications will continue to work together for the next few years. For Citrus TV News, I'm Ilana Epstein. Guys, back to you.
Ilana Epstein, thanks so much.
And the SU Athletic Program is receiving a new donation to upgrade its athletic complex. Former healthcare executive Howard Fanstyle and his wife Louise are giving SU $5 million. They say it is a tribute to SU football legend Floyd Little. SU says it will name an atrium entryway in the complex after Little.
New York Governor Kathy Hochul is extending the COVID-19 state of emergency in New York through March 16th. This comes as COVID case numbers continue to fall rapidly since the Omicron surge in mid-January. Now, the order allows the state government to sustain emergency powers. These include supporting vaccine distribution and enforcing other regulations related to the virus. Governor Hochul lifted New York's indoor mask mandate for businesses last week.
Now, the latest on COVID cases here at SU. There are currently 71 active cases. That's an increase of 19 since yesterday. This includes 24 new student cases and 5 new employee cases. The positivity rate remains at 1%.
Last night saw the return of the annual Media Cup basketball game to the Carrier Dome, the first time in 2 years. The game is between the sports staffs of WAER and the Daily Orange. Citrus TV reporter Peter Elliott is live outside the Carrier Dome with more. Peter, what can you tell us about last night's game?
Oscar, good evening. The Carrier Dome is a venue reserved for games between some of the best student athletes in the country, in football, in basketball, and in lacrosse. But last night, it was a venue reserved for a game between some of the best student journalists in the country.
Dominate on three. 1, 2, 3, dominate!
Journalists wearing jerseys. The writers, reporters, and broadcasters who cover SU athletics getting a chance to step out from behind their computers and microphones and into the spotlight. The Media Cup is an annual basketball game between the sports staffs of WAER and the Daily Orange, a friendly contest that pits two neighboring journalistic institutions against each other.
It was really cool. I've seen it for the last few years. I've never been a part of it. Really cool to be a part of it.
Tuesday night's game was a celebrated return to the Dome after COVID forced last year's game to be played at a nearby park. The Loud House, it wasn't. But the lack of fans didn't mean the game was any less intense than an ACC contest. The WAER squad had extra motivation to come out on top. They were eager to snap the DO's 4-year winning streak. The radio station seniors, like Chris Carripel, didn't want to graduate without claiming the cup.
It means a lot for the station. We had a lot of chatter from the DO the last few years. A couple quotes, a lot of bulletin board material. Happy to be back in the win column. I think we had
the two teams, hitting shots like they hit deadlines, went down to the wire. WAER led for much of the first half, but the ink-slinging Daily Orange squad wouldn't go away. But in the end, it was WAER's shooting, physicality, and unorthodox footwear that led them to a 58-46 victory. The next morning, WAER celebrating in a way only they could.
Chris, the long wait is over.
Over the airwaves.
WAER took down the Daily Orange 58-46 inside the Dome. Senior Captain Jared May.
The Media Cup has been an annual tradition between WAER and the Daily Orange since the 1980s, when it started as a football game. Now, decades later, it remains an event circled on the calendars of student journalists here at SU. A time for the press to play. Reporting live outside the Carrier Dome, I'm Peter Elliott, Citrus TV News.
Peter Elliott, thank you. A big win for WAER after 5 years.
And a longtime shopping mall in Clay is reopening. The Great Northern Mall was closed for nearly a month after a frozen pipe burst. The mall has been in operation since 1988. Most stores in the mall have since closed, and only about a dozen tenants remain.
And a local fan favorite restaurant is getting national attention. The Food Network says Pastabilities in Armory Square has some of the best Italian dishes in the country. The restaurant is featured on their list of best pasta meals. Now, I don't know about you, Ashley. I have been to Pastabilities. It is fantastic.
Oh, it's so good. You know, every time I go there, I try to get something new, and I just can't bring myself to do it.
Have you had the chicken riggies?
I haven't. Is that your favorite?
It is a favorite dish of mine. It's fantastic. It's really good, and congrats to Pastabilities on that selection.
Yeah, definitely a favorite restaurant of most students in Syracuse, I would say. And the city of Syracuse says the Waste Management Department experienced delays this afternoon. Residents who did not have their recycling picked up today will have their recycling picked up tomorrow. The city says they are expecting to have recycling delays for the remainder of the week.
The Onondaga County Sheriff's Office says a 78-year-old man with dementia has been found almost a day after he was declared missing. Syracuse resident David Warbell was located driving on the New York State Thruway earlier this morning. Warbell has now returned to his family. Now, Ashley, the weather today, it was windy and it was warm. Yesterday was really, really cold, so a nice change of pace there.
Yeah, today was almost in the 40s. You know, yesterday I was freezing. It was so cold those past couple days, so it was a nice change of pace, even with the wind.
Let's go to our weather anchor, Olivia Maniscalco. Olivia, what can we expect this evening with the weather?
Yeah, I mean, going back to what you guys were saying about the wind, if the autumn of the day was four words, it would be wind. But if we had to do it five, it would be winds, plural, because it was so windy today. 44 degrees, though, which is pretty nice, but it really didn't feel that way with the, well, right now we have 23-mile-per-hour winds, and earlier it was worse, but right now it is 23. It feels like 35 degrees outside, so it definitely feels a lot colder than 44. I would not recommend going outside right now, or you might get pushed over by this wind, honestly. But tonight, it will be around 45 degrees when you're going to sleep, but it will be getting warmer overnight going into our weather tomorrow. But yeah, it'll be about 45, 46, 47 with those heavy winds continuing. So definitely just stay in your bed tonight. There's no reason to go outside in that wind, like I was just saying. And then for the current temperatures in upstate New York, we have 44 in Syracuse, like I said. Up north in Fulton, it is about 43. Rome, 41. And it is about the same type of temperatures everywhere, but I will have to say it is the worst winds are here in Syracuse, so lucky us. That's all I have for right now. Back to you guys.
Libby Maniscalco, thank you. And coming up on News Live at 6, Ukraine is holding a National Day of Unity as many fear a Russian invasion. We have the latest updates on tensions between Ukraine and Russia.
And the Winter Olympics in Beijing are starting to wrap up. Find out who leads in total medals and where the U.S. currently stands. Stay with us.
Look at you. You're at the top of your game. You're unstoppable. Nothing can throw you off track. Wait, is that your car? Uh-oh. Yeah, I saw that coming. That will throw you off track. You're looking at around 10 grand in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Let's try this again. Smart move. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
I see you mobbing over her. Let's go. Let's mob. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Hey, yo, we mobbing. Come on, girl. Let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl.
They took over my bedroom. Come on, come on. Okay, Dad. One, two, three. Dad! You saved me. Dad?
Are you okay?
I'm fine, dear.
Your hero needs you now, and AARP is here to help. Find the care guides you need at aarp.org/caregiving.
If you see news happening on campus,
Syracuse, or across the nation, call the Citrus TV Newsroom, 315-443-1177, or tweet at Citrus TV News, your campus news leader.
Welcome back to News Live at 6. The U.S. and NATO say Russia is still building up troops around Ukraine. Moscow says that it is pulling troops out of the border region. However, the head of the United Kingdom Defense Intelligence says that Russia is moving more field hospitals and military assets to the Ukraine border this evening.
President Biden said yesterday that as many as 150,000 troops are gathered near Ukraine's borders. U.S. officials are urging all Americans to leave Ukraine immediately.
ABC News has reported that President Vladimir Putin told his military forces to be ready to invade by today. It remains unclear on whether Putin has made a final decision on invasion.
Biden made a plea for worldwide diplomacy yesterday, yet also warned that a Russian attack on Ukraine will be met with, quote, overwhelming international condemnation.
President Biden is ordering the release of Trump White House visitor logs. The former president is pushing back and claiming executive privilege. This all comes as the House committee continues their investigation into the events of January 6th. Congress is looking to see who is allowed to enter the White House on that day.
White House counsel Dana Remus says Biden considered keeping the records private, but decided it was not in the best interest of the country to do so. The Biden administration voluntarily discloses visitor logs on a monthly basis.
The Arizona State Senate voted today to outlaw abortions after 15 weeks of pregnancy. The vote was led by Republican majority leaders in the state.
A similar bill from Mississippi is currently in litigation at the Supreme Court. Many expect that case to be ruled on in June.
The stock market dipped today for the fourth time in 5 days. The recent struggle in the market directly comes from the international concerns relating to Russia and Ukraine.
U.S. manufacturing output rose in January for the first time in 3 months. News Live at 6 will have more on this later in the show.
Now it's day 12 of the Winter Olympics in Beijing. Sweden started off the day defeating Canada in the men's ice hockey semifinal. South Korea took first place in the women's 1500-meter speed skating final.
On the men's skating side, Canada's team took home gold in the 5,000-meter speed skating relay. Norway still leads with 28 medals. Meanwhile, the U.S. stands at 19. The games will continue to go on until Sunday.
Coming up after the break, I'll have the 5-day weather forecast, and spoiler alert, it's snowy. See you soon.
They told me a bottle couldn't dream. That I would never become a superhero. But I learned how to fly. Just to come back in a new disguise and be the hero that I've always wanted to be.
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable. With you that time you felt most alone. And with you when you realized you would never be. They were with you when you shared your love with the world. And with you when she became your world. Your girls have never left you. They're still with you right now. But how well do you know them? Knowing your breasts can save your life.
From the Citrus TV Weather Center, this is SU's most accurate weather forecast.
Getting into that 5-day forecast tomorrow, it will be 52 degrees, which is basically summer. It's like we're in Cabo, but it actually will be raining, so it probably won't feel like that. High of 52 and a low of 23. Then going into Friday, those temperatures are going to be dropping. It'll be a high of 26 and a low of 16 with that Syracuse snow that we all love. And then going into Saturday, game day against Boston College for men's basketball, it'll be a high of 30 and a low of 14, so it'll probably be feeling pretty nice in that dome as it snows outside. And then going into Sunday, the temperatures will be a little bit higher than before, a high of 42 and a low of 35, with just some with just some, well, there will be some snow, but it'll be mostly some clouds, luckily. And then going into Monday, it will be mostly cloudy, but a high of 54, which is totally amazing. We are super grateful for that here. And then a low of 36, no snow to be seen. And then tomorrow will be some rain. It's better than snow, but when you wake up at 9 a.m., it will be 50 degrees and raining. It'll be kind of a gross day with some clouds, some rain all day, 15 to 25 mile per hour winds. So we are not completely done with that crazy wind we had today. And then by 12 p.m., it will be about 51. And then by 6, it will still be 51. So the temperatures are going to stay about the same with that rain. That's all I have for you guys right now. Back to you.
Our weather anchor, Olivia Maniscalco, thanks so much. Americans sharply ramped up their spending at retail stores last month. The Commerce Department says retail sales jumped nearly 4% from December to January. Though inflation is part of that rise, economists believe most of January's gain is from more purchases, not higher price points.
Last month's increase is the largest since last March, when many households received a federal stimulus check. The 4% increase is likely fueled by pay gains, solid hiring, and advanced savings.
Coming up in sports, something happened to Syracuse women's basketball for the first time since 2014 last night. Plus, women's lacrosse is already bringing home national awards. Who was recognized? What happened in 2014? I have those answers after the break. News Live at 6. We'll be right back.
You've messed up your son's haircut.
Mom?
Do you A, try to fix it?
Like it never happened.
B, work with what you got? Or C, show solidarity?
Thank you, baby.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
And now, your Citrus TV Sports Report.
Syracuse women's basketball has had a season of streaks. 3-game losing streak, 6-game winning streak, 6-game losing streak. Welcome into sports, I'm Jaron May. The Orange were riding 2-game consecutive wins into a battle with Florida State last night. The Seminoles came into the Dome just 1 game above 500, themselves desperately needing a win. Did SU keep its winning streak alive? Well, let's roll the tape to find out. The Orange were wearing their pink uniforms in breast cancer awareness, and Florida State started hot all from the outside. The Seminoles knocked down 3 of their first 4 threes. Sammy Puises had 2 of them. But then the Orange started to crawl back into it. Christiana Carr knocked down a triple. She had 3 in the first half. Chrislyn Carr also putting one up. We have a tied ball game right now, 18 apiece. But then Morgan Jones, one of the best players in the ACC, oh so smooth, right to the basket. She finished with a game-high 21. Tisha Hyman tried to keep her team into it. She was 1 of 4 SU players in double figures. But Jones and the Seminoles just too good, and they would get another win, a 73-67 W. After the game, Vaughn Reed talked about how the second half was his team's demise.
job with points in the paint. And obviously they came out right away in the third quarter, started pounding the ball inside. And then later in the third quarter, early in the fourth, they were just attacking us off the bounce and kind of hurt us with a few ball screens as well. So well, I just got to do a better job with that.
As the basketball season winds down, LAX season, which is spelled L-A-X-S-Z-N, is just getting going. Syracuse women's lacrosse opened its 2022 campaign with two wins over the weekend, downing number 13 Stanford and interstate foe Binghamton. When I say they won, I really meant that they dominated. The Orange have an average margin of victory of 10 goals, in large part thanks to Megan Tyrell. The attacker has been named USA Lacrosse Magazine National Player of the Week. In her first two games, Tyrell recorded 14 points on 11 goals and 3 assists. If that's not impressive enough, the senior accounted for half, yeah, half of SU's goals in game number one. Now Tyrell is second in the country in points and leads her team into a matchup with number 4 Stony Brook this Sunday. Transitioning to the pros now, whether you're a Knicks or Nets fan, you have a game to watch tonight. New York hosts Brooklyn in the Garden in just over an hour. Neither team has been great recently. The Knicks have lost 12 of their last 15, while the Nets finally snapped their 11-game losing streak on Monday. Brooklyn is expected to be without its three best players in Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving, and Ben Simmons. Tip is set for 7:30. That game will wrap up in perfect timing for you to switch over to NBC and catch the Olympic women's hockey gold medal match. Make sure you have your red, your white, and your blue on because this is the U.S. taking on its friends to the north, Canada. This is now the sixth time the two North American rivals have battled for gold. The two countries met a few weeks ago in the preliminary round where Canada bested the U.S. 4-2. Puck drop tonight is at 11:05, so get that coffee ready. Guys, back to you.
Jaron May, thanks so much. And when we return, our weather anchor Olivia Maniscalco is standing by with your five-day weather forecast next on News Live at 6.
They call me Maxie, but I prefer tripod. I was your above-average four-legged homie, and then wham-bam minivan. Some people pity me. Now that's lame. I still run, fetch, and swim. And the ladies love me. I'm the ultimate wingman. Just don't ask me to high-five.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
Every time I hear the alarm bell go off in school, I think it's an air raid.
A lot of houses in our neighborhood have been destroyed.
I like to close my ears and sing songs whenever the bombs come close.
I'm worried our new neighbors won't like us.
But I know it's all gonna be worth it.
I just want my family to be safe. But these are not my
words.
These
are not my words.
These are not my words.
When you wake up tomorrow, it'll be raining and 50 degrees. Not the best weather ever, but you will be okay because going into the weekend, it will be a little bit better. Back to you guys.
Our weather anchor, Olivia Maniscalco, thank you so much. Hopefully the good weather sticks around. That's all the time we have today on Citrus TV News.
For more of the latest, follow us on Citrus TV News on Twitter or check out our website at CitrusTV.com.
For all of us on Citrus TV News, I'm Oscar Offerman.
And I'm Ashley Wenskoski. Have a great night, Syracuse.